Now, the chairman of Bharat Missile Limited was watching a program on TV wherein the Prime Minister was addressing the nation on the necessity of developing a self-reliant India. He subconsciously nodded in agreement and smiled to himself as he mentally reviewed BML's journey in the past 2 decades. BML had admirably progressed from using first-generation anti-tank guided missiles to designing and producing the state-of-art ATGM weapon systems that would be the envy of any army. He sighed in reconciliation with his assumptions that the government would probably not alter the status quo of a ban on export of military weaponry. Now, here the first paragraph talks about what a chairman of BML thinks of, is thinking. So he is taking pride of the BML's journey that it has started from designing of an ATGM to a world-class weapon, state-of-art ATGM weapon that is envy of any army. And they wanted to export it. To his surprise, the very next day, he got a telephone call from the DG, Ministry of Defense, asking him to discuss the modalities of increasing the BML production of ATGMs, as there is a probability of exporting the same to a friendly country. So here, the BML chairman wants that government should not alter the status quo, so that there can be an export of this military weaponry. At the same time, to his surprise, the same kind of phone call he has received from the DG of Ministry of Defense that we will formalize the modalities to export the same weaponry. The DG wanted the chairman to discuss the details with his staff in Delhi next week. 2 days later, at a press conference, the defense minister stated that he aims to double the current weapons export level within 5 years. This would give an impetus to see when you are exporting something, you get money. With that money, you can further invest in research and development of another advanced weaponry in the or you can indigenize further more weapons. So that is what they said here. He also stated that all indigenous arms manufacturing nations have a very good record of international arms trade. Now, you are the chairman of BML. What are your views on the following points? As an arms exporter of a responsible nation like India, what are the ethical issues involved in arms trade? List 5 ethical factors that would influence the decision to sell arms to foreign governments. See, when you are reading this case study, you should be able to recollect something called concept of just war. Hope, I don't know how many of you heard about it or not. There is something called concept of just war. I'll tell you while discussing this case study in the coming slides. So here, it is nothing but it is talking something called what is war justified or is there something called just war? So how to call a war that is just? When you see, war itself is unethical. So how to make it justified? So there are certain factors to call it as a just war. So we will be discussing in the coming slides. Now, so this is the quotation of something called US president, former president, who says that every gun that is made or every warship that is launched or every rocket that is fired signifies that in the final sense, the amount that we are spending here is the theft from those who are hunger and are not fed and those who are cold and those who are not clothed. So if you are making a gun, if you are making a warship, it simply means that you are diverting the money that is required to feed up your poor people. Instead of doing that, you are diverting it to somewhere else. So it is nothing but you are robbing few people of their food, clothing and shelter, and you are putting that money into weapons of mass destruction or weapons of destruction. So you can use the statement of former US president to this case study. Now, what are the ethical issues involved in this case study? We all know that India is a peace-loving nation. The Article 51 of Directive Principles of State Policy, which says that one of the directives of the state given by the Indian Constitution is that it should settle the disputes in a peaceful manner. Now, by exporting arms, are we not questioning the stand of the Indian Constitution? Now, we have something called the father of nation who always cherishes in non-violence. But our exporting of arms goes against this principle. Now, India is a land of 3 great religions, that is Hinduism, Jainism, and Buddhism. One of the principles of Jainism is that Ahimsa. Now, what if they are misused? See, you are exporting this arms to another country. They may be used against ourselves also. They may be they these weapons may get land in the hands of terrorists, or they may be used against innocent civilians, or they may be used to create a fear psychosis. So these are all the ethical issues that are involved in the exporting of arms. Now, okay, what are the ethical we as a nation should, or you will consider before exporting these arms to another country. So I will export these arms to only to that country that abides by or respects the international conventions with respect to arms usage. Or I will export this. See, these are the five factors. Then we call this war as a just factor, just war. That it should be, you should use war as a last mean for the purpose of self-defense, but not aggression. It should be only as a last resort. Now, the proportionality element, that is, you are starting a war. The amount of gain by starting this war should be much, 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 much larger than the loss. The probability of success should also be very, very, very high. It should be used with right intention. And this war should be declared by proper authority. That is, only by those leaders who are legitimate. When I am saying a leader as a legitimacy, means he should be elected by the people in a free and fair election process. So when these factors are fulfilled, then you call it as a just war. Now I will be exporting arms to those countries which fulfill these factors. Now you can write all these or any one of these factors as one of the factors that decide my arms export program. Now it should not be used against its own civilians. Do not export them to any other third country. Now if you are satisfied that your arms needed for a particular country to ensuring only minimum deterrence, not for aggression. Now you will be exporting this to only those countries which follow the policy of no first use. So you can write all these factors. I'll be taking in consideration ethical factors that influence my decision making in selling the arms which are made by my country to other foreign nation. So you can choose any five best among this. Now, what should be the conclusion? See, my conclusion should be that I should always uphold peace process. For example, see what happens is that in a conflict resolution, if you are trying to solve a problem between two people or two nations through domination, see that the World War I is a result of domination of one nation over the other nation. World War II is a pure compromise of Germany with respect to other nations. It has resulted in World War II. But when all the nations are brought on an equal platform, when there is a proper integration, we have not seen any world wars after World War II. If there is a domination, if there is a compromise, if there is a domination of one nation because of access to weapons, if there is a subjugation of another nation because of compromise, because of lack of weapons, it will result in world wars. We have seen this, and these are the clear examples of this. And it is a fact. You can quote this fact in the conclusion. So, and you can conclude that peace cannot be kept by force. It can only be achieved by understanding. Albert Einstein. So, you can quote this world history example in the conclusion. So, why? Because arms exporting is not a good option. Because if you are using those weapons for domination, or if it is resulting in compromise, in both ways it will result in world is resulted in world wars. So the only way is that integration. So what Albert Einstein has said, that peace cannot be kept by force, or peace cannot be kept by compromise. It can only be achieved by understanding. This is what Albert Einstein has said. Now with this, I have completed the second case study. If you have any doubt with respect to this case study, you can please raise your doubts. Please reply me in the chat box.